I hate driving, racing sports, and racing video games. Or that's what I thought, until I gave Trackmania a chance. After logging in more than 50 hours in that game, I started thinking, if I like Trackmania, maybe I should try watching a motor racing sport that is similar to it. So I decided to try Formula 1 and see maybe I like it. And like most people, first thing I did, opened YouTube, looking for some Formula 1 highlights. Watched some race highlights, watching some cars zooming, and saw some horrific crashes. It was interesting. Also, commentators are doing a great job hyping up overtakes and highlighting some impressive racing performance. That kept me entertaining for a while, but I got bored and went back to watching my guilty pleasure, Grey's Anatomy. And then it hit me. While watching the cheap-ass drama unfold over the screen, I started thinking, how can I enjoy this? And not enjoying people putting their life on the line, racing to the extreme limits. The solution is, I need some context, watch it, and get invested in it. Have storylines to know, who to cheer for, and who to root against. Some underdogs I can sit behind, and a favorite, take down. And then, I saw the missing link to all this. That will hopefully give me that piece of puzzle that I'm missing. Formula 1, Drive to Survive. Before watching the first episode, I was bracing myself for a documentary that either focused on the journey of the current drivers or chronically followed a single driver or a team. However, to my delight, the show exceeded my expectation. Formula 1 Drive to Survive, which not only navigates the entirety of an F1 season, but does so in an expansive manner. Starting from the 2018 season, it brilliantly captures intriguing events spanning across different teams throughout the course of the season. It's not merely a behind-the-scenes tour of races, but rather an immersive journey that combines intense on-track action with off-track drama, politics, and the human stories, presenting a wide view of this high-speed world. This approach can turn almost anyone who just picked up this show and have no clue about Formula 1 into the biggest fan. The series is a fascinating combination of diverse personalities, from drivers, owners, mechanics, and directors, all striving for excellence or the grandest stage. It spotlights all of the teams and drivers and their inspirational drama, politics, and ambition, presenting a full season distilled into 10 40-minute episodes that offers a unique showing of the events that unfold both on the circuits and behind the scene. It brings the adrenaline and intensity of the races, the dynamics of the padlock, and the strategic maneuverings into sharp focus. Whether you are drawn to the tenacity of an underdog or the might of a titan, Drive to Survive provides an all-access pass to the world of Formula 1, allowing you to connect with a team or a driver and passionately root for them. This comprehensive insight not only caters to hardcore F1 enthusiasts, but also invites newcomers to understand, engage with, and appreciate the thrill of Formula 1. Since I'm a sucker for the drama and storylines, without spoiling much, let me narrate for you some of the event that get me hooked to the screen. Let's look at the story of the newest team that joined Formula 1. The American team, Haas. Team Haas is a new Formula 1 team that joined in 2016. And at the start of the docu-series, they'll be entering their third season. Not equipped with the same budget as other teams, Haas has one of the smallest budgets in the competition, but with a supportive and passionate owner, they are struggling to keep pace with the other team. Finishing in 8th place in both 2016 and 2017, in 2018 season, the team must aim for higher positions in order to keep its reputation respected. With a Ferrari engine and two respected drivers, well, fuck me. I just spoiled myself for season 3 and 4. Well, great. Great. Anyway, let's get back. With a Ferrari engine and two respected drivers, driver Kevin Magnussen, an impressive talent who started F1 in 2014 and finished on his first season ever with Team McLaren on the 9th spot out of 20 drivers, which is an impressive for rookie year. But that season still remained his best coming into 2018. This season is his to prove. The second driver, driver Roman Grosjean was considered a veteran compared to his mates. Roman and Kevin presenting Team Haas are impressive qualifying spots, P5 and P6. That means they start the race, position 5 and position 6. With a steady pace, up to that point in time, Team Haas never finished the race higher than P7. So the hopes are high for these two drivers to start the season with a bang. The race starts. Kevin and Roman keep their spots, and halfway through the race, Roman goes to pit to change his tire and check the car. To continue, he says to look around, and in the pit, one of the mechanics did not adjust the tire perfectly and left it loose. And just like that, the first driver retired and was not able to finish the race. Team Haas manager Gunther Steiner is fuming in the paddock. The mechanics are confused and the driver is furious. But the manager tried to collect himself. He still have one more driver to lead into a victory. And with another pit coming soon, everyone in Team Haas is stressed and on the edge. Kevin comes to pit. They need to focus not to repeat this mistake to keep this historical round alive. Tension is on. Car is in the pit. Here I am, watching, waiting to see how they handled it. Trying to resist the urge to Google the outcome of the race. Let's see if they save it. And they screw it. Well, not really screw it, because one of the screws on the tire is loose. And just like that, the second driver is out. And their historic run is dead. Both drivers did not finish the race. Imagine this, the car is performing well. The drivers are doing a phenomenal job, and because of one of the mechanics, screw up. Not once, but twice, they lose the race. All of this happened in episode 1. And by the way, there is another interesting story in episode 1 as well. And just after that episode, I was immediately hooked. Grey's Anatomy season 19, you have to wait because I found my new best friend. Formula 1 Drive to Survive has experienced an exponential increase in viewership over its 5 seasons, with the latest season attracting a spectacular 1.2 million viewers. For Formula 1, this manifests as expanding fanbase, increasing viewership, lucrative sponsorship, and ultimately, an enhanced quality of competition and entertainment. After finishing the show and with a bit of reflection, it's evident that the series creator embarked on the show for their gain. However, the superior quality and genuine passion infused into the show have evidently proved an immense boost for the product itself. The successful model prompts further exploration, with this approach being implemented across an array of other sports. Shows with the same depth, love, and passion can certainly act as a catalyst to boost viewership and overall interest in these sports. Such shows not only humanize the personalities involved, but the behind-the-scenes access, emphasis on storytelling, and exploration of the dynamics of competition contribute to a more profound appreciation and understanding of the sport. So yes, other sports could definitely benefit from this style of programming to enhance their global appeal and reach. At the end of this video, I would recommend that everyone go check out Formula 1 Drive to Survive. But before that, check out the Formula 1 rules and the structure of the league, because the only flaw of the series that it does not introduce the rules for casual viewers. If you do not want to do that, well, I have 2 words for you. Thank you. And thank you for sitting around this video. If you made it this far, make sure to subscribe for more random videos like this. And as always, see you soon. Bye.